Chapter 5, Neuro. In this video, we will focus on various treatments for attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, also known as ADHD, and also for bipolar disorder. So we'll start with the medications used for attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or ADHD. So ADHD is a developmentally inappropriate inattention and hyperactivity that comes from functional impairment in different settings of life. It's thought that it's caused by deficits in an area of the brain that's associated with behavior and problem solving. So one of the treatment modalities that we use to treat that is a stimulant to increase activity in the brain. These stimulants are the longest studied, they've been used the longest, and they work quickly, so they're a pretty common choice in therapy. So for our stimulants, we have dexmethylphenidate, or Focalin, and methylphenidate, or Ritalin and Concerta. New medications have been produced that are non-stimulants, which work the same way on norepinephrine and dopamine, but they are not controlled, so they don't have any abuse potential. The stimulants are controlled. So our non-stimulant example in this video is atomoxetine, or Strattera. And the ending of the atomoxetine is not to be confused with that of fluoxetine, which is an SSRI. Bipolar disorder is a disorder that causes shifts in mood and activity levels, so it can lead to extreme emotional highs and hyperactivity, and they call that mania, or extreme lows, which present as depression. Someone with bipolar disorder can have episodes of mania or depression or both, and so we treat people with bipolar disorder with mood stabilizers. And so the example today is a simple salt, and it is lithium or lithobid. So let's work through some practice questions. So question one, a medication that is used for ADHD with no abuse potential is, and so for this video, A will be dexmethylphenidate, B will be methylphenidate, C will be atomoxetine, and D will be lithium. So the correct answer is C, atomoxetine. This is the only non-stimulant medication that is approved for ADHD. So A and B are incorrect because those are both stimulants, and D, lithium, is incorrect because although it is a non-stimulant, it is not used for ADHD. So now we will go through all of these drugs again, and we will change the question to make it correct with the answers. So question three, make A correct. A stimulant that contains the D enantiomer of another stimulant is A, dexmethylphenidate. So molecules are often made of two enantiomers, and an enantiomer is just when a molecule has a mirror image of a different molecule. So the dextro enantiomer of methylphenidate is more pharmacologically active, and that is the only component of the dexmethylphenidate. So B is incorrect because methylphenidate contains the active D enantiomer and also the less pharmacologically active L enantiomer. And C and D are incorrect because those are non-stimulant medications. Practice question four, make B correct. A stimulant that is available as a capsule, tablet, chewable tablet, suspension, solution, and patch is B, methylphenidate. Methylphenidate is available in all of these dosage forms, and it's also available as short, intermediate, and long-acting durations of action, which is really helpful, especially in kiddos if they aren't able to swallow tablets or capsules, and it's nice to kind of have that patient specificity, especially with the short, intermediate, and long-acting as well. So dexmethylphenidate is incorrect. It's only available as a capsule and a tablet, and it's also only available as short and intermediate acting. The atomoxetine is not a stimulant, it's only available as a capsule, and lithium is incorrect because it is not a stimulant, but it is available as a capsule, tablet, and solution. Question four, make D correct. A medication used for bipolar disorder that can affect sodium levels is D, lithium. So lithium was the only medication in this video that can be used for bipolar disorder, and it does affect sodium. Lithium is a pretty good mood stabilizer. It's one of the oldest we have, and it's very effective in preventing suicide, but its use has fallen out of favor because it has a lot of negative side effects. It can cause tremor when lithium levels are a little high. It can cause renal dysfunction. low thyroid levels. It's also not safe in pregnancy, and it has a small therapeutic index. And what that means is that the target dose is close to the toxic dose and the ineffective dose. So we have to have tight control and regulation of the lithium with a lot of lab tests to make sure that the lithium level is where it needs to be. So it's kind of fallen out of favor.